Hello everyone, I am a Huawei training instructor. In this lesson, we will learn about storage resource optimization techniques and applications together. That chapter mainly discusses the related technologies of storage resource tuning. This includes features such as SmartThin, SmartTier, SmartQoS, SmartDedupe, Smart Compression, and Smart Migration. Then through learning, understand the business characteristics of various functions, implementation principles, and application scenarios, etc. Firstly, in this chapter, we will learn about the SmartThin feature, think about why to use SmartThin, what kind of features it has. Let's take a look at the overview of this lesson. There are some problems when deploying traditional storage systems. For instance, the first one, when expanding storage space, it may affect or even interrupt our business system. That is, when the data volume grows beyond expectations, we need to adopt expansion measures for the storage space. The more complex the business system, those assist, the more difficult it is to expand. Next is the uneven utilization of storage space. Over time, as the IT system is used, some businesses will have an excess of storage space. There are still some operations, but there is not enough storage space. However, the excess part of this space, the storage space, cannot be transferred to businesses that lack storage space for use. So this utilization rate is unbalanced. The third one is that the storage efficiency is relatively low. When planning the storage system, if your business data volume is estimated at its maximum, the initial investment cost will be relatively high, which can easily result in a large amount of idle space. And the resources and space overheads you spend on maintaining these spaces in the later stage are also quite large. To address these shortcomings, we use SmartThin technology to provide this automatic storage thinning configuration feature. That is, when creating RAM, it does not really configure specific space. Instead, when the user actually needs to use this space, I will allocate the corresponding actual space. And the unallocated space, as a public space, can be allocated to any RAM that needs space. In this way, the utilization rate and efficiency ratio can be improved. At the same time, we adjust the dynamic space. It provides the ability to adjust the size of online RAM space. It can be expanded without affecting its business. Next, let's take a look at the working principle of SmartThin. The key to the working principle of SmartThin lies in the virtualization of storage resources. Like in this picture, this is our physical space in the real machine. Form a storage resource pool from the disks in the storage array. Then it is mapped for our server to use. However, for the host, it is when we present the storage space to the user, it presents this kind of logical virtual space. We use SmartThin, which creates ThinLun. It will create a ThinLun. For users, this SmartThin, it will not pre-allocate all the space. It presents to us users a capacity form that is larger than the physical storage space. So what the user sees, for example, my physical machine might just have 55 TB of space. As for the server, if we use ThinLun, suppose I create an 8 TB, then present it to the user server. However, the physical space of my actual machine may only be 5 TB. So for the user, I have 8 TB, you allocate me 8 TB. So am I using this much all the time? Its data flow is definitely how much you use. For example, if I want to store a TB of data traffic in it, then in the physical space, I will arrange it according to this requirement. I can just assign it an actual physical space of 1 TB. For the user, I think I still have 7 spaces of remaining space. However, this remaining 7 TB of space, it does not occupy actual physical space. It's just a virtual concept. So this is our SmartThin. Then the user uses as much as needed. I just need to allocate it according to the needs. Give as much as you use. If it is said that the user's capacity, storage space, and physical space are insufficient, then I will expand the system later by increasing these storage units. The entire expansion process does not require system downtime. So for users, it is completely transparent. That is, the business is uninterrupted. Next, we analyze the read operations of SmartThin through a diagram. As shown in the figure, the host sends a request to our ThinLun. After the ThinLun receives this request from the host, it will first query the mapping table of ThinLun and pool. That is, there will be a mapping table in the middle. The function of this mapping table is to record the mapping relationship between the logical storage area here and the actual storage area on this side. So during the writing process, it will dynamically update this mapping table. During the reading process, it will query this mapping table. Then let's take a look. Querying this mapping table, there are two types of results. One kind is that you can find the actual storage value. It has already allocated actual physical space to this virtual storage area. There is also one that is not allocated. Then let's take a look. If we say we visit a pair like this, it has already been allocated actual physical space, then the host will perform a read operation in this area. Read the corresponding data and return it to our host. The space has already been allocated. If it is found that no actual physical space has been allocated at this time, it will return all zeros to our host. So this is our read operation. Here, it is about how to check this mapping table. It has one that is from a directional one. Use this to find the corresponding to build such a mapping table. So this is our read operation. Then, the SmartThin write operation. Let's take a look at the host sending write requests. Write IO request to our ThinLearn. ThinLearn also receives this request. It queries the mapping table between ThinLearn and pool storage area. Let's confirm this pool. It's about whether the storage area has already allocated actual storage space to our ThinLearn. For example, we query one here, found existing pairs in the mapping table, exists on this table. So what about pool? It means our actual physical space has allocated space inside this logical storage area. So we will focus on this area regarding this actual physical area. What about the storage area? To carry out data write requests, write operation, that is to write data into it. If this write request, it is to free up space, that is to perform space release on this side. This is already allocated space. If we talk about querying this mapping table, I found that no actual physical space has been allocated in my storage area. What should we do? At this time, it will first allocate space through direct on-time technology. So it's allocated on demand, right? First, we allocate space for it, allocate this space to it, and then form such a mapping relationship through direct on-time. Then write data into this space. Proceed with the write operation. So this is our write operation of SmartThin. In this case, it will involve a technology called direct on-time. One is our COW technology. It is about time allocation, copy on write technology. What about COW technology? In fact, it is a mapping relationship allocated according to the principle of realism. It will randomly map to determine. So about this learn, when reading and writing to this area, it needs to redirect one of the two relationships, the relationship between the two. This redirection depends on this mapping table. So the redirection operation of direct on time divided into read redirection and write redirection. So overall, this is our write operation for SmartThin. So it can be seen that the role of this mapping table is crucial. So finally, let's take a look at the application scenarios of SmartThin. Based on the features of SmartThin, our SmartThin can be applied to the following scenarios. For example, the bank bill trading system. As for this kind of business, it is generally required for businesses with high continuity, a core. System business. In terms of this kind of business, we can then use the SmartThin feature. The system can be expanded online without interrupting our business. It can also be used in the mailbox, cloud disk services, and other corresponding application data. What about the application system data? Its growth rate cannot be accurately assessed. If I adopt SmartThin, then can allocate physical space on time, physical storage space, avoid the waste of this resource. For example, it is used in our carrier services because there are various types of operator services. So the types are also different. Its business requirements are also different. Its space requirements are also different. Then if I use SmartThin for this operational configuration, it allows different businesses to compete for this physical storage space, implement the optimized configuration of our physical storage space. So this is an application scenario of SmartThin. Finally, let's take a look at the configuration process of SmartThin. We are considering using this storage system. If you use this feature of SmartThin, First, we need to confirm whether we have this license permission. If there isn't, we need to obtain a license, then import this license. Next, we can create storage space. Create storage space, that is to create a hard disk domain. Storage pool, then create thin LUN. Operations on thin LUN. We can go to modify its attributes. You can proceed with online operations, online expansion. If this storage space is not used in the end, if we need to release this thin LUN, that can be deleted. So about this delete operation, it's actually a reverse push. How did you create it earlier? I will deduce from here. Then delete the thin LUN, delete storage pool, delete hard disk domain. Finally, just release the storage space. So let's conclude, review the content learned in this lesson. In this lesson, primarily studied the working principle of SmartThin application scenario. Configuration process. The focus is on the read and write operations of SmartThin through storage resource virtualization technology. Create thin LUN mapping for our users. Only when the user performs real I/O read and write operations on the thin LUN. Only through the strategy of realistic allocation. From our storage resource pool, apply for this actual physical storage space. So, about this on-demand allocation method, increase the utilization rate of storage space. And it is based on a smaller force, about grain, go organize our space. We can manage our capacity in a refined manner while saving space. It can also implement online expansion methods. That concludes the content of this lesson. Thank you for studying. See you next class.